most striking feature about him was his enormous head. The deformities rendered the face utterly incapable of the expression of any emotion whatsoever. The right arm was of enormous size and shapeless. The right hand was large and clumsy, a fin or paddle rather than a hand. The other arm was remarkable by contrast. It was not only normal, but moreover a delicately shaped limb covered with a fine skin and provided with a beautiful hand which any woman might have envied. The lower limbs had the characters of the deformed arm. There arose from the fungus skin growths a very sickening stench which was hard to tolerate. To add further burden to his trouble, the wretched man when a boy developed hip disease, which left him permanently lame so that he could only walk with a stick. He was thus denied all means of escape from his tormentors. Here was a man in the heyday of youth who was so vilely deformed that everyone he met confronted him with a look of horror and disgust. It was not until I came to know that Merrick was highly intelligent that he possessed an acute sensibility, and worse than all, a romantic imagination, that I realized the overwhelming tragedy of his life.